Namaste Yogis, welcome to today's yoga practice. Today I'm taking you through a beginner yoga sequence. This will help you build up some strength and also gain some flexibility. Even if you really don't have any experience with yoga or if you are just getting started into it, so let's get started. We will start today's session with the prayer. We'll chant Om three times and then the mantra. If you don't know the mantra, don't worry, you can just listen to me. So sit in any comfortable position with cross leg, or you can do Padmasana, lotus, or you can do half lotus, which is just one leg on top of the other leg. So this is half lotus. Or just simply cross your leg and sit comfortably. Sit straight. Bring both your palms together to your heart. If possible, close your eyes. Take a deep breath. Sahanavatu, sahano bhunaktu, sahaviryam karuvavahe, tejasvinavaditamastu, mavidvisavahe. Om shanti, shanti, shanti. Gently rub your palms to warm up. Place on to your eyes gently and on your body and slowly open your eyes. In the beginning, we will go for sitting poses. So while we are in the cross leg position, you can do half lotus and take both your hands towards the ceiling into the Namaskar Mudra. Breathe. Bring your right hand on to the right side of your mat, and if possible you can bend, and the left hand can go over your head behind your ears and chest. Open up your chest and you can look up or you can look straight. So gaze up. Few breath here. And stretch as much as you can to feel the stretch on your left side. Slowly bring your left hand up and the right hand up. Both hands into the center. Again in the Namaskar Mudra. From here, take your left hand onto the left side of your mat. Bend from the elbow and the right hand over your head behind the ear. Open up your chest towards the ceiling and feel the stretch on your right side of the body. You can take this hand as much as you can. Just stretch and feel that stretch. Breathe. Slowly come up, both your hands again into the center. You can bring both your hands down on your knees, thighs, or wherever it's comfortable. And from here, we are going to bring both our feet together. Baddha Konasana, butterfly pose. For that, bring both your feet together closer to your body. Interlock your hands and place wrap around your feet and straighten your spine, sit straight, neck straight, and start flapping your knees. So basically knees up and down as much as you can. This helps to open up the hips. Breathe normally. Gaze straight. And if desired for the variation, or if you want to give yourself a little challenge, you can use your elbow and press and just take your feet a little bit away from your body and open up like a book and press with your elbows. So the knees, as you can see, as you open up from here like a book, knees goes down. So knees go down. So you can press like this, or you can press with your elbows and bend forward as much as you can. Stay here. Come up slowly. Again, cross leg your position. And from here, we are going to go for cat and cow pose, one of my favorite. So for that, come into the tabletop position. So the hands, the knuckles spreaded apart and get the good grip here, and legs, both knees parallel, your shoulder and wrist parallel. From here, inhale, lift your head, gaze up, and drop your belly. Reverse, exhale, pull your abdomen in, spine curled, gaze at your navel point, or maybe you can gaze on to the mat. We go for four more rounds. Inhale up. Exhale down. Inhale up. Exhale down. Inhale up, exhale down. One more round. Inhale, exhale. And here you can just stretch as much as you want. any part of your body that is feeling any tension, maybe you can just release by stretching the way you feel like. Maybe go back, slide forward. All right, from here, lift both your hands from the mat and bring them on to your thigh, the front of the thigh, or you can place them on your hips. And we are going to go for camel pose. You can do half camel pose, Ustrasana, or you can go for full camel pose. So we'll start with the half camel pose first. So get into the comfortable position. And from here, lift your chest, push your hips and arch back slowly. Drop your head if possible, or you can keep it straight. Slowly come up. So that was half camel pose. So let's do it again. One more round of camel pose. And this time we can try doing it for full camel pose. So again, inhale, chest, open up your chest. Push your thighs out and your drop your head. And from here, you can come back if you're not ready yet. And another variation is you can place both your hands little on the back of the hips so that you can support your body. So again, inhale, open up your chest, push your thighs out. Now take your right hand up and hold your right ankle with your right hand. Left hand up and hold your left ankle with your left hand. So this is the complete camel pose. Stay here, drop your head slowly. Take a deep breath or breathe normally, however you feel comfortable. Slowly bring your right hand back onto the right thigh, left hand onto the left thigh, and stand on your knees. From here, whenever you feel tired, you can go to child pose. So for that, bring both your big toes together. So as you can see, my knees are apart, but I have connected both my toes, and then sit on your ankle, basically, or just the legs, the shin of your legs, as you can see. And I have about 6 inches of space between my knees. From here, you can walk in front of your mat with your hands. Touch your forehead to the mat if possible. And breathe normally. Become aware of yourself. Feel how your body is responding, whether you are feeling stretched, relaxed, calm. And you can stretch as much as you can. couple of more breaths here. Lift your head and look at in front of your mat, and slowly walk with your hands on the right side of your mat. And again, get into the comfortable position and touch your forehead to the mat. Extend your hands as much as you can, and you will feel stretch on your left side of the body. Lift your head slowly and then walk back into the center. Couple of breaths here. Lift your head again. Now walk to your left side of your mat. Feel the stretch on your right side of the body. So stretch, extend your hand as much as you can, and find the comfortable position. Your chest can rest on your knees. And the forehead on your mat. Couple of breaths here. Slowly lift your head and come into the center of the position. And again into the child pose. Couple of breaths here. Your forehead touching to the floor. Your chest can rest between your knees. Lift your head slowly and walk back slowly with your hand and come up. Child pose can be very relaxing when practiced correctly. And so at any point of time when feel tired while practicing yoga, child pose is the pose that will help you relax again. Okay, all right. So from here, bring both your knees together this time and your big toes together. Place your hands on your knees, thighs, or anywhere you feel comfortable. And coming into the Vajrasana, thunderbolt position. And erect your spine and the neck and sit straight. Close your eyes if possible and breathe normally. From here, let's change our position. Cross-leg your position. Cross-leg in a seated position. And from here, extend your right leg straight and your left leg touching the inner thigh of the right leg. And from here, take both your hands up towards the ceiling into the Namaskar Mudra, or you can just keep them apart like that. And from here, try to bend forward. And if possible, you can hold on to your feet, or you can place your hands on your shin, but try to stretch as much as you can. So for me, it's touching my feet and I can feel the stretch in my right leg. Breathe. Slowly come up. Again, come into the cross-leg position. And from here, extend your left leg and your right foot touching the inner thigh of your left leg. Take your both hands up into the towards the ceiling. From here, bend forward on your left side and feel the stretch in your left leg. Breathe. Another variation, if you cannot hold your feet or if you are not able to bend forward, you can do the stretching like this. Take your hands up and down, up and down, and eventually you will be able to bend forward. Feel the nice stretch on your right side of the body. Your forehead can touch to your knee. Just a couple of more breaths here. And slowly come up. Again, come into the cross-leg position. Now that we had a good stretch, we can stand up and we start practicing the sun salutation. So for the sun salutation, Surya Namaskar, there are 12 sequences. So come onto the front of your mat in Tadasana, standing straight and relaxed. From here, in the Namaskar Mudra, inhale, take your hands up towards the ceiling and arch back slightly. Slowly exhale and bend forward. So you're bending from your hips. And slowly try touching your mat. So as you can see, my legs are straight. You can bend slightly if you are not able to keep them straight and touch the mat and get hold of your mat by pressing your hands, your knuckles. Take your right leg back, coming into low lunge, one leg low lunge, and neck straight. Breathe. Tuck your right leg toe and extend your left leg and come into the downward dog. So basically, just push yourself back, your tailbone. Focus on your tailbone and come into the plank. From here, bend your knees and bring them onto the knees, and bend your elbows and your chest on the mat. Inhale, cobra pose. Exhale, downward facing dog. Coming on to the plank again, and then slowly bring your right leg between your two hands. Drop your knee, low lunge. Lift your head up or straight. Bring your left leg in, forward bending. Inhale up, arch back slightly, and then coming into the Tadasana again, and with the Namaskar position, and relax. We are going to do a couple of rounds here. So again, from the Tadasana position, bring both your hands together in a Namaskar mudra. Inhale, take your hands up towards the ceiling, arch back slightly, slowly bend forward. Exhale, take your right leg back, extend your right leg. Look straight, or you can gaze a little bit up. Tuck your right leg and extend your left leg. Downward facing dog. Then come into the plank. Drop your knees, drop your chest, your chin touching to the mat, cobra pose. Again, downward facing dog. Into the plank, right leg, bring between your both hands, and then drop your left knee. Slowly bring your left leg between your palms, so both your legs now are between your palms, between your hands. Bend forward position, breathe. Lift your head a little bit and inhale. Take your hands up towards the ceiling, arch back slightly. Exhale. Come into the Tadasana. We'll go one more round of Surya Namaskar. So again, in a Namaskar mudra, standing in a Namaskar position. Inhale, take your hands up, arch back. Slowly Bring your hands onto the mat, bending forward. Lift your head a little bit. Take your right leg at the back. Extend your right leg. Extend your left leg. Downward facing dog. Come into the plank. Drop your knees. Bend your elbows and your chest and the chin onto the mat. Sarvasana. From here, slide yourself and then come into the cobra pose. Your shoulders should be drawing to the back like that. And then your chest, open up your chest. And you can gaze at the ceiling. Lift your body. Come into the downward facing dog again. From here, bring your left leg in front of your, in between your hands. Dropping your right knees, low lunge, your right leg in. Forward bending, up, and relax. All right, so we're going to have a last round of Surya Namaskar. And so for that, I'm sure you don't need my instruction. So again, come into the Namaskar Mudra, standing in the Namaskar position. From here, take your hands up, inhale, and take your hands up, arch back. Exhale, slowly bend forward. This time, take your left leg, extend your left leg first, and come into the low lunge. Extend your right leg and come into the downward facing dog. From here, come into the plank. Drop your knees, drop your chest, knees touching to the mat. Glide your body forward and come into the cobra position, cobra pose, Bhujangasana. Slowly lift your body. Come into the downward facing dog again. Bring your right leg between your hands. Low lunge position. Left leg between your hands. So both feet together. Slowly lift yourself and both your hands towards the ceiling, arch back. Exhale, come into the relaxed position. So by this time, I'm sure you must have gotten a little sweat. So that was a good workout. And so from here, you can stand in a Tadasana and lift your right leg slightly and place onto your left side of your ankle, left leg ankle, or on the shin area and open your leg. So this is a Vrikshasana tree pose. This is very good pose for balancing. If you want to challenge yourself, you can bring a little bit up and place your right feet on resting onto the left inner thigh. And open up your leg and find your balance first, and then you can you can try some variations here. So for now, you can just stand in a Gyan Mudra like this. You can keep your eyes closed or open. Some other variations are you can stand and then come into the Namaskar Mudra. This is another variation. Or you can take your hands up. That will challenge you for more balance. So slowly extend your hands up towards the ceiling. And slowly come down. And now we are going to switch with your left leg. So your right leg stays straight this time, and then try with your left leg. You can rest on your, you can rest your left feet onto your right ankle, or you can rest on your shin, or you can take it up and tuck it under inner thigh of your right leg. And again, find your balance. Breathe normally. To challenge and for more variations, bring both your hands together closer to your heart. Focus on your balance. Or you can slowly take your hands up towards the ceiling. Slowly come down. All right, from here, we will do some more poses, standing poses. So just jump and bring your feet apart from each other. And from here, your right hand, you can bend towards the right side. And slowly your lift your left hand towards the ceiling and open up your chest and feel the stretch on your left side of your body. Few breaths here. You can gaze at the ceiling or you can look straight. Slowly come up. This time, your left hand on your left leg, slide and take your right hand up towards the ceiling behind your ears. Open up your chest and feel the stretch on your right side of the body. The more you stretch your hand, the more stretch you will feel. Slowly come up. And now we can go for a little more variation. We can go into the warrior position. So for that, your left leg facing straight and the right leg parallel to your knee. And from here, take your left hand up in towards the ceiling and your right hand touching to the floor. Open up your chest. Gaze at the ceiling, or you can look straight. Stay here for a couple of more breaths. Trikonasana, triangle pose. So for that, straighten your knees and your right and leg, both legs should be straight. So now come into the triangle pose. Slowly come up. And now this time, your right leg straight and then your left leg facing in front of you. And from here, you can, if you are a beginner, you can just bend your knees slightly first while you come into the position. So take your right leg up towards the ceiling, your left hand touching to the floor. And from here, once you find your balance, straighten your leg. So your both legs should be straight and coming into the Trikonasana. Open up your chest to feel more stretch in your spine, the twist in your spine. Gaze at the ceiling. And slowly bring your right leg down. Lift yourself slowly and come into the standing position. Now from here, we are going to sit down again. And you can practice some more twist, or if you just want to end your practice here, you can do that too. So I'm just going to do a couple of twist poses here. So sit and extend both your legs in front of you and your hands back. From here, lift your right leg and bend from your knees and hug your leg between your hands. And from here, take your left hand up in towards the ceiling and your right hand at the back. And then twist from the midsection of your body and feel the twist in your spine. You can keep your left hand up or you can bring it down here and press your right knee and look back over your shoulder, or you can look at the floor, however you feel good. Slowly take your left hand and right hand, hugging your knees again. Extend your right leg and bend your left leg now and hug with your hands. And from here, take your right leg up into the air towards the ceiling, your left hand back, bring your right hand and press on your left knee and twist from your midsection of the body and look over your shoulder and feel that stretch. Breathe normally. Slowly untwist your body and bring both your hands and hug your knees. Straighten your left leg and again both your legs together. Bring your both hands behind your hips. Straighten your body. And look straight. From here, you can slowly lie down onto your mat. Bend your both knees and twist on your right. Both your knees resting on top of each other, or you can extend your right leg out and the left leg resting on your right leg, and your hand straight onto the other side, and now twist on your left from the midsection of your body. Stay here. Breathe normally. Slowly take your leg in, come into the center. And from here, we twist on our left. So twist. Again, the same, your leg straight, one leg straight, and then the right leg resting on the left. And your hands can be straight like this. Close your eyes if possible. Your shoulders should be touching to the mat. Feel the stretch. Breathe normally. Slowly come up again into the center. And from here, you can go to Savasana. So for Savasana, your hands straight like this, little 45 degree angle, and your legs. And just rest here. You can scan your body. Or you can just close your eyes and chant mantras, or if you really just want to focus, maybe you can start scanning your body, experience how your feet are feeling today, your ankles, your shins, knees, thighs, abdomen, chest, waist, shoulders, hands, elbows, neck, your forehead. Just relax, breathe normally. Become aware of yourself. Savasana can be practiced for up to 5 minutes. We'll go for 2 minutes. See if you are feeling relaxed after today's practice. whenever you feel relaxed and ready to get up, roll on your right side and then slowly come up and sit in the cross-leg position or half lotus or any position that you are comfortable with. And we end today's practice with some good positive vibes. So bring both your palms together closer to your heart. Lower your head towards your heart. And acknowledge yourself for showing up on today's mat. May your days be filled with happy, healthy life. Namaste.